Hello everybody, and welcome to episode 1 of my new tour series on the channel. The original tour series came to an end, unfortunately, because of issues with my other world. If you watched any of the videos, especially the ending videos in that, you will know what happened. Basically, I started that world in 2017, kind of a good quick summary here, and unfortunately, as time went on, I ended up transferring the world file when my PC died. I transferred it from my main PC to the laptop, and then I transferred it back, and unfortunately I had lost a lot of work that I had put in. For some reason there was some sort of error, and the world didn't actually save or keep the save. I had been reluctant to start a new world in a while, and that was all in 2018. That's where I lost all of it. It's now December 29th, 2019. It's over a year since I last worked on that world. I've started up a couple different Minecraft worlds since then, and only played for a few minutes in each, and then stopped. Because I was just kind of bummed out about that world. But, well, everything comes to an end at some point, I guess. Starting anew, hopefully with a little bit better of a time, I have found this world. I was fantasizing in my head about playing Minecraft and having my same similar mountain base that I had in the previous world, but I wanted there to be a village at the base of my mountain base. You know, the base is in the level ground of my mountain base. And then I spawned into this world, walked for about 5 minutes, and came across a village located in a very beautiful location. This is a very big village, and there is a, I think that's the flower forest over there. And you can see that there is a gorgeous river here that goes underneath the mountain. These mountains aren't as big as I was hoping, unfortunately. Don't worry, we'll go and sleep in just a minute. But it does look like a good enough area to set up shop. And basically what I'm going to do, since this is the first episode, and there's clearly nothing I've done yet. I mean, this is my inventory. I just started. I am going to give you kind of a sort of idea. I've gotten a good look around the vicinity, and I'm going to say, you know, here's what I want to put here and here, so that you can kind of look at the evolution across the videos and decide. And you can kind of decide how well it's come along, and if I've completed the various things that I wanted to complete. So, yeah, I look forward to that. Waiting for the sun to go down before I really show you, but you can see the village here. It's pretty barren, but I think we can spruce it up a little bit. I've gone through some of the chests, but I haven't taken anything out of them. And here we've got some of these trees I was growing over here. As you can see. And the mountains go further back, but we'll take a closer look at that in just a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to come over here and sleep in the same bed I slept to skip the last night. And the village goes further on that direction, too. And there is an iron golem here. Now, I've never actually played... This is update 1.15. I've never actually played the villager-pillager update, really, so... That was an entirely new sound. I don't have... Yeah, see, respawn point set? You couldn't do that before. There's a lot of quality of life updates that have been made. And because this is the default texture pack, I can see they've done a lot of changes to the textures, and I can't say I find too many of them to be that great looking, but... I don't know. I'll probably look for a proper texture pack at some point. So I wanted to set up over there, but unfortunately the water, I don't want to obstruct the water too much. I was going to fill this in with dirt and then set up my base there, but I don't want to do that because I want to keep the water feature as is. Maybe I'll build a bridge and stuff over it at some point. I definitely want to make this part of the fortress. Hollow it out, have glass windows and balconies and stuff and walkways. I think that would look really nice. But as it stands right now, I found a different place, which is not too far away, right here. So it's not as secure as my other world's location was, but we do have kind of a natural wall here, and I'm going to kind of start building into it. And this is going to be the outside, kind of. And I was thinking that wall, the similar wall that I had built in my other world, I would like to set up. So, for example, I want to have, I might have the wall connected here, and it'll follow along this here. Since this is kind of what this I'm going to consider as level ground, I'll probably flatten this out at some point. I'm going to have it kind of go along down here, and then once it hits about that little hill, I'm going to have it branch back in, and it'll connect with this wall, so that I have kind of a little exterior portion. Now, if we go up the hill, there is some more stuff that I think will be worth looking at. Go back over here, up. Okay, and then up here we have the back portion, and thank fucking Christ I don't live in yet another taiga biome. You can see there is taiga biomes that way, but thankfully there's actually a nice mix of biomes around here. And this I wanted to make kind of the center of the fortress, maybe. So, like for example, I'd have the wall connecting over there, and then I'd have the wall connecting those two places and those. So it would be similar in style to my previous world, but the mountains here are not as tall. They're much lower to the ground. So that might cause some issues with my construction design. But you can see in the distance that there are far greater sized mountains. Now, I had my render distance up much higher earlier, and I saw a huge formation in the distance that would be great for a base, I think. The only problem is it's, well, too far away, and I want to build next to the village. I think I could always build another fortress out there. So that's kind of what I'm deciding right now, walls throughout this place. Of course, that probably won't come for a while because building walls will take a lot of time, a lot of prep work. There's a lot of resources that need to be gotten. One thing I just noticed is that there's actually not many farms at this village. I'm used to there being tons of farms, but as far as I can tell, there's one. And then they've got some like cows and pigs in a pen, which is neat. This is all new stuff to me, pretty much. I never Villages weren't like this before in my other world. And like I said, I want to make this nice rock formation over here into some form of fortress as well. A kind of an extension of the fortress. Okay, so I'm getting spammed with messages, which you guys can probably hear. And we're going to come back down. And I put this pillar here just to kind of mark my territory. This is where my workplace is going to be. So I don't really know where to put the house. There's also seeming to be a natural cave here that goes down, which might, my other base didn't have that, so that might be useful. I don't exactly know where to set up my house yet, but I'm going to set up shop over here. I'll set up like a temporary little hut or something. And I'll take lots of screenshots, and they'll all be posted on my Steam again in case you want to keep track of it there. But yeah, other than that, I just wanted to make a kind of an introduction episode to the new tour series so that you can kind of get a quick rundown of what I plan to do with this world. And we'll see how much progress I make, if I make any.